Either you support the idea of free speech or you don't. For the record, and before getting into this story, I am fully supportive of the transgender community, but I do not support the idea that you have the right to police the thoughts and words of others. If you truly want to be accepted by society, then this is not the way to go about it. It was reported yesterday that Doctor Who writer Gareth Roberts had been dropped from a Doctor Who anthology over offensive tweets from, quote, pressure from the show's fandom and co-authors. To clarify, this did not come from the majority of Doctor Who fandom, but from a small subsection that seems hell-bent to destroy the franchise so their feelings aren't hurt. You don't really need to destroy the Doctor Who franchise anyway, because it's doing a pretty good job of that on its own. This controversy came as the result of a tweet from 2017. In that tweet, Roberts made a joke using not approved politically correct language. He said, "I love how, I'll skip the word, choose names like Monroe, Paris, and Chelsea. It's never Julie or Bev, is it?" Any sane person can see that this was simply meant as a joke, but edgy comedy has been outlawed. Well, unless it's at the expense of straight white males. You can say whatever you want about this group, and nobody bats an eye. Double standards are in full force here, and I know firsthand what happens when you garner the wrath of the triggered basement minions that call themselves Doctor Who fans. At this point, I just find their hate humorous. Roberts posted his side of the story on Medium back on June 4th. So rather than look at this through the lens of the shill media, let's look at Robert's side of the story. This is what happened recently. I'm keeping it simple and factual to avoid any ambiguity. Good, but facts are a mere suggestion to this group. I was commissioned by BBC Books to write a short story for an anthology of Doctor Who stories. I've written several Doctor Who episodes for TV and many Doctor Who books for BBC Books and for Virgin, the previous license holder for Doctor Who fiction. I completed and submitted the work. The publication of the book and its authors was not intended to be announced until early June, but some details, including my contribution, were leaked accidentally. I wonder how that happened. At this point, a section of the Doctor Who fandom agitated for my removal. Oh, I know that section very well. They've been trying to have me silenced for 2 years. Also, contributing authors to the book, I don't know who, threatened to withdraw if I was involved. Virtue signaling at its finest, folks. BBC Books immediately folded to these demands. Not a surprise at all, and a perfect example of why Doctor Who is dead. And I was informed that although I would be paid, my story would not be published, as they judged, wrongly in my opinion, that a potential boycott would make the book economically unviable. These tweets in September 2017 were cheerful vulgarity, like every other reasonable person. I deplore and condemn any violence, intimidation, or discrimination against any person for their beliefs, or for how they present themselves, or indeed any other reason. What a toxic statement that is. When I was a kid in the 1980s and a member of the London lesbian and gay teenage group, we referred to ourselves and each other, and again, I'll skip the words. I note that one of these words is somehow an official initial for the ever-expanding lexicon LGBTQ, used now by the British royal family and the Conservative Party. I find this irritating, but I would never try to prevent people from saying it with force or sanction. Freedom to offend is not an attack. Some have urged me to make a full, obeisant apology. Even if I was inclined to, I don't think it would have any effect at all. For example, Helen Lewis of The New Statesman is currently being monstered for the most careful, respectful piece on this issue. I'm not bothered very much by words, though I'm bothered when they distress my friends and family. But then, that's how intimidation works. That's why intimidators intimidate, and I know for a fact it would be much worse for a woman in this position. For the record, this is my opinion on transgenderism and ideology, with no humor or irony attached. Let's remind the basement dwellers in my comment section. For now, people still have a right to their own opinions. These are just words, and words can't hurt you. Triggering is just a sign of your own inherent weakness. I've rejected restrictive cultural stereotypes for as long as I can remember. I consider them to be very harmful and constricting, especially for girls and women. The culture I enjoy most, and the artists I like most, are people who laugh at, bend and play with these roles. I don't believe in gender identity. It is impossible for a person to change their biological sex. I don't believe anybody is born in the wrong body. Again, This is Robert's opinion, and it's not one I personally agree with, but he has every right to say it. We have the freedom to say and do as we want. This is not hate speech. This is Robert's giving his honest opinion, and this, for now, is something that's allowed. From my view, you can change between the two genders as you want, but this does not give you the right to special treatment, nor does it give you the right to police the language of others. I think it's wrong to write a falsehood into law, compel people by law to speak words they do not believe, rewrite the law to remove women's biological sex-based rights and protections, reinforce gender stereotypes, medicalize children who don't conform to gender stereotypes. That's it. There you go. Roberts believes the same thing as you guys in some areas and not in others. Just like many people. The next statement hits the nail on the head. I don't believe my view should be protected either. People must be protected. Ideas must never be. I would ask the writers who objected to my inclusion in the same book as them to reflect on that. My opinions on transgenderism are neither extreme nor unusual. It would be interesting to know if BBC Books Random House would be prepared to pull from publication writing by Sharon Davies, Graham Linehan, Linda Bellows, Robert Webb, Jermaine Greer, Lionel Shriver, Julie Burchill, or Martina Navratilova. Well, it depends upon whether or not a snowflake hate mob descends upon them. Then the BBC would fold pretty fast. Roberts is fully within his right to say what he wants, whether you agree with it or not. He has proven himself to be a brilliant writer, and removing him from the Doctor Who brand will only further damage it, and it really can't afford any more damage right now. You do not have the right not to be offended. I don't necessarily agree with everything he said, but I will fight tooth and nail to protect anyone's right to freedom of speech. And that's it for today. Don't forget to subscribe, and make sure you're still subscribed because YouTube is deleting subscribers, and follow me on Twitter. And as always, everyone, thank you for watching, and have a great day.